YouTube, this is Michigan Snow Pony or Renee. And a question I frequently get on my channel is, what do I do with all the milk that I get? I have two alpine does that are currently milking, and I'll get, this is a half gallon, and there's a quart for comparison, but I will get two of these, almost two of these, every morning, and then about one of these and a quart at night. They don't give as much as at night for some reason. That's a lot of milk every day, 7 days a week. But there is so much you can do with milk. Take a look. It's cooking. It's almost ready. Scalloped potatoes and ham with our own potatoes and our own goat's milk. Just a little bit more about the cheese I've been making. Those of you that have followed my channel for a couple years know I have struggled with making any kind of cheese with my goat's milk. And this year I finally got the hang of it. At least a soft cheese. And what I make is very comparable to cream cheese. And I use it just like cream cheese. My goal now is to never buy this again, because after I make the cream cheese, or my Chevre, as it's called, soft goat cheese, you can freeze it up to 6 months. So that is what I've been doing with my extra milk. A lot of it is I've been freezing it up, making the cheese, freezing it up, very simple process. Then after I get it out, now this is some I used for that veggie pizza that was in that shot. This is the leftovers. And what I'm going to do is add some ground up herbs. This happens to be some wild chives that I think they made it into a video earlier this spring. And I dried them in the dehydrator, chopped them up, but not that fine. But then what I do is I put them in my little grinder, and they get really fine. These are going to be lovely to add to this cream cheese. Or I add garlic salt, or basil is another good one, and dried tomatoes. You can do so much with this stuff. And you don't add that until after you thaw it out. If you've frozen it, you add all your spices and herbs that you want afterwards, and you freeze it just plain. But I'm really happy with it. I finally got the texture I want. It's very creamy. And every recipe I've tried it in so far that I normally would use cream cheese, this stuff in, it works beautifully. I even made a cheesecake with it. Everybody liked it. So I'm finally happy, and eventually I'm going to I'm going to try hard cheese. I got to work my way up to it. But I did go ahead and I bought a little cheese press. Zoom over here. I bought a little cheese press here off eBay. It's not very big, but it's good to start out with, and I'm going to be making the attempt. I will probably do a video on making soft cheese. I'm feeling a little confident. I've had it turn out quite a few times now, so I think I can make a video. This is my little ice cream maker, and yes, you can make goat's milk ice cream. Take a look. I didn't put it in here and make it look very pretty, but this is vanilla. Where are the kids? Mmm. Oh my gosh, this is the best ice cream I've ever had. Oh my gosh, it's good. And so easy. The reason it's a little yellow is because it takes 4 egg yolks in it. And sugar, egg yolks, cream, and you can skim the cream off your own goat's milk, or you can buy cream. Goat's milk and a little vanilla. And with the exception of the sugar, all those ingredients I have homemade. So, or I produce myself. So, and it is, that's all that's in it. There's no preservatives, nothing else. Wonderful. That's going to be our dessert tonight. That, and I just have to show you these watermelons. Oh, look, this one is especially quite good size. These are the moon and stars. There's the moon. They always have one spot that's bigger. And there's all the little stars. So we're going to cut one of those open and have that for dessert as well. You can tell watermelon is ripe, incidentally, by, you look at the stem, but the stem end, and the little tendril, the little twisty tendril that comes off, when that turns brown and dry, the watermelon is ripe. And that's the tendril closest to the watermelon. So when it's brown and dry, the closest one off the stem, pick your watermelon. Another good indicator, but not always, you can't trust this one, is that there's a yellow spot underneath. But check your little tendrils right next to the stem, and that usually is a good way to check. The girls are having a sleepover tonight, so they're taking this one to their company, or their place that they're going to have as a snack and a thank you gift for relieving me of my children. But let's get back to this anyway. So I got to put my ice cream back in the freezer. I probably do a video on that. It's coming. But I'm just so ecstatic to get the cheese finally. 3 years, see? Everything in homesteading, guys, it's a process. It's a learning process. You're going to have failures. The pigs are very disappointed that I finally mastered it because they were eating pretty darn good out there. And, by the way, your extra milk that you have is great to supplement your chickens and your pigs with. And the whey that you have left over from making soft cheese, great pig food. They love it. Okay, that's all, YouTube. Till next time.